All right, I thought today I'll speak on a topic that is slightly, I don't know, maybe of interest to young boys and men, young men, but older men, especially married ones, will know what I'm talking about. And I'm not yet decided on the heading of the topic, but it would be something more in how to satisfy women, how to keep women happy. Okay, and what do I mean by this? I'm not talking of just sexually, or I'm talking about a relationship where you're together, like marriage or something like that, long term. But the main goal is to keep this person happy and this relationship for a longer duration. So what is the one secret by which you can keep a woman happy or a relationship long lasting? Now, I can tell you without a doubt that this secret that I learned was thanks to my mentor, who himself was married, but he was not a playboy. I was a playboy. My mentor was not a playboy. But he gave me these words of wisdom, and at that time it didn't make sense. But over the years, as I've learned to apply it, I've realized he's absolutely right. So what is the secret? The secret is this. Make sure that you give less than the best. Or don't keep your the expectation level so high that you can't be consistent. I'll give you examples to make you understand what I've said. Now, for example, my wifey now. I can easily give my wife, let's say, $1,000 a month, okay, as pocket money or to spend whatever she likes. $1,000 a month.
Why is that puppy barking?
Okay. I can give my wife $1,000 a month. However, even though I can give $1,000, I have not given her anything. In fact, I never even told her I'm going to give you $1,000. So what do I do? What do I give? I give my capacity that I can give $1,000. So if your capacity is $1,000, the thumb rule is don't give 1,000. Sometimes give 800, sometimes give 200, sometimes give nothing, sometimes give again 100, but never give your full capacity. Always give less than that. Like, last month, I managed to make a good close of sale. Good customers, quality customers, well-paying ones. Now, I thought I would give my wife, let's say, $2,000 or $3,000, and she saves it. She doesn't spend it. She saves it. So I could have given my wife $2,000 or $3,000. And I was almost going to, like, you know, sometimes you have this impulsive feeling, okay, I'll give my wife a gift or something. So instead of giving my wife the $3,000, what I did, I kept it in the back of my head, okay, $3,000. And I gave her just 500, okay? I gave her 500 and I said, this is for you. My wife was grateful, she was thankful, because I didn't tell her anything. I didn't tell her how much money I'm making, nothing. And that's another thing. Never tell your spouse how much you're making. Others, they'll always, oh, you made this much or you spent this much. What about me? No, never do that. Let it always be hidden as far as possible. So thankfully, because I earn a unpredictable income, there's nothing fixed. However, if your wife or spouse knows how much you're making every month, then there's an expectation, which is a problem. And especially if they expect something and you don't meet that, then there is even more problem. So I give my wife 500. After 2-3 days, she normally expects only once a month. After 2-3 days, I gave her a gift that I bought from one of these online stores. Then after another 2 days, I bought a baby a nice gift. Then after 2-3 days, I took her out for food. So what I did is unpredictable. But every 2-3 days, a small surprise, you know, one day food, one day a cold drink, one day she likes shrimps. One day I bought 1 kilo of shrimps. She was very happy. So on. But I don't do that every day. Sometimes for 1 week, there's nothing. Okay? And now here's another tip. Don't say yes every single time. See, sometimes my wife says, can I, she always asks me, okay? She never buys anything without asking me. I do not know what is your relationship with your partner. If your partner is working, obviously your partner will not ask you. But if your partner is dependent on you, or your partner has to ask you, remember, never say yes for everything. Because if you say yes for everything, they take you for granted. Now my wife wanted, let's say for example, one day my wife wanted a squid. You know, squid, it's not expensive. But she wanted squid, and I knew that in the house there is already food. You know, sometimes in the freezer there is food. So my wife said, let's buy a kilo of squid. I said, no, there's food in the house. We'll finish that first. She was a little upset, and I kept quiet. I didn't think much about it. And then she, you know, kind of made a like a grumpy face. And here's another thing. You should address the issue before it escalates out of hand. So I asked her, why are you making a grumpy face? She just kept quiet. Then she said, you know, I wanted squid. You said no. I said, I can say no whenever I like. I can say yes whenever I like. You shouldn't expect. You should be grateful. You should have gratitude. At least we have food to eat. Don't take life for granted. And I punished her by not giving anything expensive in the house for food or anything. We ate just rice. Even me. It's not just my wife is punished. We ate simple food. Why? Because I want my wife not to forget her roots. That we came. She came from a life of poverty. I came from a life of poverty. And oh, here's another tip. We never waste food. Huh? Never ever waste food. If for example, I'm eating a burger and the burger falls from the table on the clean floor, not on sand or something. I take it up, dust it, I eat it. I tell my wife, no throwing food. Even when you buy, we buy good food. We don't buy cheap food. Like when I buy the orange, suppose half the orange is overripe, I cut off that part and I eat the rest. I know many of you, oh yuck, what? No, I came from very poor backgrounds. I came from humble beginnings. We don't take food or blessings for granted. And I was not born with a silver spoon up my ass that, oh, this orange is a little spoiled, throw the whole thing. No, even if the orange is spoiled, I cut off that part, I eat the rest. Even apples, sometimes my baby eats a little apple and leaves it. I tell my wife, no throwing this food. Because if you throw, then I'm not going to bite the next time. So nothing is thrown out. Now obviously that doesn't mean I keep things until they spoil. So like I was telling you, the squid I didn't buy. And because she showed a grumpy face, there was a punishment. I didn't tell her it'll be for 1 week. I told her, no more squid. She kept quiet. And she knows if she takes things for granted, she'll never get. So I kept quiet for a week. She totally forgot about it. One fine day, I surprised her by buying nice squid. There was a good one. I bought it for her. So this way, she was really grateful, you know. So the main thing is, never give so much that the person takes you for granted, where the person doesn't realize the value, where the person feels, oh, this is my, I'm entitled to this. Because when a person feels I'm entitled to this, that's where the fucking problem takes place. And if, for example, your capacity is $1,000 and you push yourself and give 2,000 or 1,500 or whatever, then for that person, this new standard that you put, this will always be the benchmark by which they will evaluate. Oh shit, he gave me 1,000 2 years ago. He gave me 1,500 now. Oh, he gave me 2,000 this year. I'm expecting 2,500 next year. I'm expecting 3 the following year. Human greed, whether man or woman, never stops. And then they'll want more, 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 and then it'll fucking drive you mad. Because, you know, it's like a well. No matter how much you put into it, it'll keep sucking it all. So even for my wifey, I keep things in check. So if my capacity is up here, I give till here. Up, down, up, down, up, down. And most important of all, remember, keep things for a rainy day. because you do not know when you'll need emergency, like hospitalization, getting sick, someone's death in the family. Like my mentor used to say, if you have the money in the bank, if you have the power, you'll always have the respect. But if you don't have the ability to take care of your partner or take care of the expenses, you will lose your respect just and it'll go faster than, like they say, faster, it'll drop faster than Enron stock. So all I want to give you through this video in a nutshell is always keep things in check. Always keep things moderate. Don't overdo something to a point where you can't maintain that standard for the rest of your life. Because if you go way beyond your means, you're finished. Then you cannot sustain and survive. So for my wife, always take care. I give a little. And yes, one last bit of advice. Make sure that the person earns your kindness. Make sure the person earns your blessings or rewards. And you also, like even for me, I work hard for my wife by proving that I show my love by working hard for them, by saving money. So in the same way, my wife, she has to also work. See? See, she's working. See? If she doesn't do housework or she's lazy or something, you know, there is punishment. Punishment by, if she didn't do the housework and she later on, after I told her she doesn't do it, evening when we go shopping for food, no, she'll not buy. I told you to clean. You didn't clean. Once you clean, then we take. Sometimes I have to be the father, you know. So, the dad of the house. Man of the house. So, I know this might sound silly, but these are some of the tips that I'm giving you through life. Always remember, longevity is a secret of success. Being consistent. Not a one-time hit wonder. One time you do so great, and for the rest of your life, you can't manage or maintain. So anyway, I hope this video added some value to you. Here are some life lessons. Okay. Having said that, hey, Yogi. Yogi. Okay. So then let me know your thoughts. This is me signing off. You guys take care.